My long white socks halfway up my legs, long blonde hair tied up in the usual sporty ponytail, and my Velcro shoes buckled. That was my first day of kindergarten, and needless to say, I got to choose what I wore. Holding my mom's hand, I walk into the kindergarten classroom, and I say, "Ew, Mom, this room smells." To my dismay, my kindergarten teacher was standing right behind me. But that day, I learned how much of a perfectionist I would be and how easily I would share my opinion.
This injustice led me to give this address, which is to tell you that the life you are about to lead will be inherently, incessantly, and necessarily unfair. Don't be fooled by this ruggedly handsome exterior. I don't need more of that. I've had my share of disappointments in life, and I'd like to think that most of these were unearned on my part. Thankfully, time constraints preclude me from sharing each of them with you, so instead I'll just share one that I think illustrates my point. Many of you know that a year ago last January, my four-year-old son Lucas was diagnosed with cancer. He underwent a dangerous and complicated surgery followed by a lengthy and painful chemotherapy regimen. What he wanted didn't matter, because he couldn't give up. He had to keep fighting. After some arguing and a lot of tears, his response was, "Okay, Daddy, I'll just deal with it." This became his personal motto in response to the pain, fears, and adversity he faced in the following months. As I struggled through that period, I kept thinking of John Donne's Meditation 17, especially the passage where he wrote, "Affliction is a treasure, and scarce any man hath enough of it. No man hath affliction enough that is not matured and ripened by it, and made fit for God by that affliction." Now, I've probably read that passage close to 100 times, but until dealing with my son's sickness. And I realized that I have been made a more fit husband and father as a result of it.